The death of a loved one is not something anyone wants to talk about. But for these families in Wellington, it's a necessary conversation, especially when talking about how their families will be taken care of after they're gone.
Sometimes when you say about the will, and then sort of upset them a little bit because, oh, you're not going yet.
I'm very open with my son. And yeah, he sort of understands the gist of a will and what it is about and what we are leaving to him, even though he is only 11.
When the destiny of a great fortune is at stake, men's greed spreads like a poison in the bloodstream.
In movies, this is how the reading of the will is portrayed. But the reality is different. Families will already have a clear idea of the plan and what needs to be done.
It's not that American scenario of everyone is going to the lawyer and nobody knows what's going to happen until, you know, they get told if they get something or not.
Wellington-based solicitor Emily Hartson-Maea wants to break those stereotypes and make the process of completing a will easier for our Pacific families.
They need to realise it's more than just property. It's their way of actually talking to their family when they're no longer around to be asked.
For some people, that time could be sooner than later. The point is to be prepared as much as possible beforehand.
Being under 30, I say it's never too early to do something like that, especially when you've got children.
It's some sort of a security for our children's future. And to know that when we are not around anymore, then that our children has something to fall back on.
Experts in wills and estates, the public trust, have found that less than half of New Zealanders are making wills. Their research also showed 80% of Pasifika didn't have a will, and 69% of Māori are also missing out.
A lot of people think it's almost tempting fate, but it is of such importance, and this is where the focus needs to be on family and loved ones as opposed to you personally.
Having a will serves many other purposes, particularly the role that spouses and partners have to play.
A lot of myths out there as well. A common one is that if you have a husband or wife or a partner, that you think, if I don't have a will, it's fine because everything will go to my partner and that's what I want to happen. Sometimes that's true, but it's not always true.
They don't realise just because you're the next of kin that you have no legal authority to deal with any of the estate of the person who's passed away.
But for those families who have made it a priority, their advice is to take the first step to get legal guidance.
When you've gone and your partner's passed away, you know at least you've done all you can and your children are safe. So I advise to go and do it, go and get it done.